Hey, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, you'll learn how to automatically update catalogs in Meta Commerce Manager, formerly Facebook Commerce Manager, using Plytix channels. There are actually two ways of bulk updating your catalogs in Meta Commerce Manager, using an XML feed or using a CSV feed. In this video, we're going to look at the XML feed method. If you want to learn how to do this using a CSV instead, then check out the link in the description and subscribe to our channel so that you get notified when we publish this video. Also, before you watch this video, you may want to check out our video on general channel creation to get an idea of the basic process. But if you'd rather jump right in, then let's go ahead and I'll guide you through step by step. First things first, let's set up an XML channel by navigating to the Channels tab of your Plytix account. Select Add Channels and choose the XML option. Remember to give your channel a name that lets you recognize the purpose of this feed easily. For example, Facebook or Meta Catalog. Now that we have our channel, we need to add the information that we want to include for the products in our catalogs. We'll do this by adding attributes, which are data points about your products, like size, price, description, technical specifications, variations, and so on. You'll do this from the Attributes tab here. You can select as many attributes as you want to appear for your products. You can also create computed attributes, which use a formula to alter your existing attributes in a way that you might not normally use, but that can be useful for selling on Facebook. For example, you probably store price as a decimal attribute in Plytix, but Facebook requires that you add a 3-digit currency code. By using a concat formula, you can create a computed attribute that uses the price you already have in Plytix and adds USD for dollars or EUR for euros. This is just one way that computed attributes can simplify how you share your product data. You can learn more about computed attributes in the video that I'm linking here or by checking out our Help Center article that I've linked in the description. Next up, let's choose which products you want featured in your catalog. We'll do this from the Products tab of your channel. Here you'll select the product list that contains the products you want to sell. If you don't have a product list yet, you can create one here, or you can also create product lists from the product overview page and from the product lists page. I'll link the video where I explain how to do this in the description below. Once you've selected your products, it's time to format your channel feed. It's important to make sure that your channel generates a feed that's readable by Facebook. And to help with this, Facebook offers samples of what the right kind of feed should look like, which you can see here, and I'll add it to the description as well. So let's navigate to the Format tab to make sure that your feed matches theirs. The first thing we'll do is add a node by clicking the Add Node button at the top of the feed builder. We need to call this node RSS, and we need to add 3 XML attributes to it. These create a sort of frame for all of the product data that we want to share by telling Facebook what kind of information to look for. And because this is something that'll be the same for anyone creating an XML feed for Meta, you can save some time by just copying and pasting the information here to your own channel. You can find a link to this in the description of this video. Once your XML attributes are complete, click OK. Now we'll add a channel node below the RSS node, and you can do this by clicking Add Nodes at the top of the feed builder like we did before, or click the Add Subnode icon on the RSS node. Depending on which one you do, double check that the parent node is set to RSS and make the node tag channel. Next, you'll be adding some subnodes to the channel node. Click the Add Subnode icon on the channel node and make this node tag something that signifies the name of the catalog that you're creating. This time, we're gonna tick the box next to Leaf Node. This means that we're creating a node that won't have any subnodes. For Leaf Node content, add your catalog's title, and when you're ready, click Add Node. Repeat this process to create leaf nodes to provide a brief catalog description and link. We're almost finished with leaf nodes, but we have to add one more. And for this last leaf node, we'll do something that's slightly different. The node tag needs to be Atom Link, and from the Closing Tags drop-down menu, we'll choose Self-Closing. Doing this creates the code that allows us to group together the 3 XML attributes that we're including in this leaf node. Click Add Attribute 3 times, and again, the article I included in the description below has the elements so you can copy and paste them. When you're finished, click Add Node, and you should see all of your leaf nodes in the feed builder beneath the channel node. Now, you may have noticed from the sample feeds that the names of the attributes in your feed builder don't match the required Facebook fields. But that's okay. You have all of the right information, so all that you need to do is make sure that Facebook knows where to find it. To do this, you have to format the node tags of your attributes. So start with the orange products node and click the edit node icon. The edit node panel will appear. And here you'll rename the node tag from product to item. For each attribute subnode beneath the products node, we'll make the node tag match Facebook's required field name. This will ensure that Facebook can find the information associated with each attribute. You can reference Facebook's documentation via the link in the description to find out what each attribute node tag should look like in order to successfully upload to your catalog. And when you're finished, your feed builder should look something like this. The last thing we need to do before we process the feed is delete our topmost node. It's the one that's labeled products. Just click the delete node icon and voila, your feed is ready. We do also recommend that you set up scheduling at this point, which you can do by navigating to the settings tab. Select the dates and the times that you want your feed to update so that any changes you've made to your product information in Plytix will be synced to this channel's feed at regular intervals. Make sure you've saved the changes to your channel, then click the Process Now button and start processing. Once your feed has been processed, you'll see that a link appears below the channel's name. To copy this link, click the copy icon right next to it. All that's left to do is head to your MetaCommerce Manager account, go to the catalog area and paste the URL of your feed into the data sources section under data feed. You'll need to follow a few steps here on Meta side of things to schedule how often Meta should fetch information from the feed, meaning how often your Meta catalog should update with the information in the feed. You'll also need to name your feed and select a currency. When you're done, select upload. Once the upload is complete, you'll be able to see all of the products from the feed appear in your catalog, which means that you've successfully created an XML feed for MetaCommerce Manager. Now that you understand how to get your products from Plytix to Facebook, why not take a look at one of our other videos, like how to optimize your product listings to rank higher and sell more. I hope you find this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to reach out to us. If you're a Plytix user, you can email your customer success agent or reach us by chat at plytix.com.